Okay, let's climb the statue. I don't see the need to waste it. I need to upgrade axes also. There is a harp there. We need to light the brazier. There are two. Thank you. Oh, it opened because... Oh, for fuck's sake.
Phoenix stumbled upon a winged creature, easily mistaken for a fairy. However, its true identity would soon be. As Phoenix freed the small creature imprisoned on the isle, she let out a cry, which meant, "Great hero, I am but a piece of Nike, the goddess of victory. Please free the others, so I may return to my full glory."
They won't win without Nike. She's like a glove or a thing you wear that protects you while running. A helmet. So, what is it?
Phoenix would need to free it to find out.
Yeah, but you can tell me now.
Can you please respect my narrative pacing?
I'm wondering that too.
Ah, the Valley of Eternal Spring. Its highlights include a massive tree that reaches up to the heavens. The Hall of the Gods. Eros's Palace.
Oh, I'm glad he finally got his happy ending.
And a palace belonging to the Goddess of Beauty herself.
Of course Aphrodite would claim the prime real estate with the best view. As long as she's safe from prying eyes, I'm happy.
From such great heights, a fluttering of birds, feeding from the most beautiful apple tree, caught Phoenix's eye.
Phoenix was about as high as I was when I thought marrying Aphrodite off to Hephaestus would stop the other gods from fighting over her.
Yes, that view from Mount Olympus is something else. I haven't seen it in years.
You're not getting that high again, so stop asking!
Damn.
Well. Well, let's start Tegeus. That I'm interested in.
Tell me the deeds of golden Aphrodite, who subdues mortal men and birds in air, and the creatures on land and sea. Grant me a song, stir up my sweetest passions.
Hey, watch it, buddy. That's my daughter-in-law you're talking about.
Okay.